In this video, we're analyzing a problem where a block is shot by a spring on a smooth surface. After the block flies off of the spring, it hits this rough surface and slides to a stop. And the point of this problem is to use the work energy theorem at each step. So we're not quite using conservation of energy in its fully developed form yet. We're still framing everything in terms of the work energy theorem. So we're told our block is 700 grams. It's squished into this spring that has a constant of 120 newtons per meter. I'll go ahead and copy that number down here. It's squished by 35 centimeters in its initial state and released from rest. And then the rough patch well to the right of the equilibrium position, that has a coefficient of friction given by 0.18. In part A, we want to compute the work done by the spring as it returns to its equilibrium length. Now, because the spring is exerting a force to the right, and the mass is moving to the right, that work is positive. And in a previous video, we've already derived the formula for the work done by a spring, and that turns out to be 1/2 kx², where x is the compression distance from the equilibrium position. And this is assuming it returns all the way back to its equilibrium position, which it does in this problem. So I just plug in k, 120, initial compression distance, 0.35, you gotta square that. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 7.35 joules. Now in part B, we're asked to use the work energy theorem to compute the maximum speed of the block. So remember, the work energy theorem says that the net work done on an object results in a change in its kinetic energy that I'll call delta K. We could write that as K final minus K initial. Because everything starts from rest here, the initial kinetic energy of the block is zero. So it's just the net work done on this block results in the final kinetic energy. And since the spring is the only thing doing work on this block, I can write the work done by the spring results in this final kinetic energy, which is given by 1/2 mv². Now this is before we've hit the rough patch. We can go ahead and solve symbolically for v. I multiply both sides by 2, divide by m, and square root the result. So my symbolic solution is that v is twice the work done by the spring, divided by m, and square rooted. Plugging in the numbers, I get 2 × 7.35. Divided by 700 grams, well, that needs to be converted to kilograms. That's 0.7 kilograms. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, I get 4.58 meters per second. Finally, in part C, we want to use the work energy theorem to compute the sliding distance for the block once it hits the rough section of the surface. In other words, instead of thinking about forces and accelerations, we need to think about the work done by friction here. So I'm going to bring the block into the picture while it's still sliding. And now we can bring in all the forces for the block. And there are 3 forces to think about here. I have the force of gravity pulling down on the block. I have the normal force pushing up. And that's going to be equal in magnitude to mg because there's nothing else tampering with the vertical direction. And then finally, the friction force is given by mu k, the coefficient of kinetic friction, multiplying the normal force. So as that block slides to a stop, the friction force is doing negative work because it points exactly in the opposite direction of the displacement vector. Now I can apply the work energy theorem, the net work on this block, and this is during the sliding to a stop process, is equal to the change in kinetic energy, and that's the final kinetic energy minus the initial. And in this case, it's the final kinetic energy that's zero because the block slides to a stop. And the net work, that's given by the negative of our friction force multiplying the displacement. And on the right-hand side, we have the negative of the initial kinetic energy. Now there's 2 ways you could go here. You could go ahead and write the initial kinetic energy as 1/2 mv² and plug in the v that we got in part B of the problem. But there's no reason to introduce compounded rounding error here. I know the initial kinetic energy was 7.35 joules. So we'll go ahead and keep that kinetic energy term just as a k initial. I still have to plug in the details of the friction force here. That's mu k times the normal force, but the normal force is mg. So I end up with negative mu k mgd equals negative initial kinetic energy. The minus signs cancel, of course. And I'm able to solve for the sliding distance d. And I can write that as the initial kinetic energy divided by mu k mg. Now we're ready to plug in the numbers. And I get 7.35 joules. Divided by this kinetic friction coefficient of 0.18, the mass of the object, 0.7 kilograms, and g, approximately 9.8 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, we get 5.95 meters for the sliding distance. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.